everyone, and welcome to Vlogmas Day 18. Vlog kind of late. Oh, just lost my slipper. It is 3:48. I spent the whole day editing the Whistler trip footage. There was just so much footage to go through. I thought I was gonna be able to edit it in like a day, but it ended up taking me like 2.5 full days to go through all of the footage. And if you watched the vlog, then you know I was having some issues with some of my earlier clips in the vlog and had to do like a lot of work to make some of them at least a little bit usable. But we're starting the vlog. We haven't eaten yet. We're gonna have some Uncrustables. We picked some Uncrustables up yesterday when we went to grab some stuff that we had in our mailbox because the border is gonna be going back to doing the PCR testing for Canada to US. So we won't be going to the US until they get rid of it because it's super, super expensive. It's like $200 per person and it's a whole hassle to get it done and have to like go within a certain time window and stuff. And that starts on Monday, right?
Tuesday? Monday night for midnight? us, like at 9 p.m. our time.
Yeah, and Sebastian was supposed to go back to the States today to grab something, I guess, for me.
Yeah.
Probably. And wasn't able to. They, like, something went wrong with his shipment, so now his thing is supposed to arrive, I think, on the 22nd, you said?
Yes.
Which is after the whole rule thing kicks back in place, and obviously all because of, like, the Omicron variant and stuff, they're being extra cautious with travel, cross-border travel. Yeah, I don't know. He has to figure out what he's gonna do, but he's been stressing about that all morning.
Huge pain in the butt.
Yeah, so anyway, sorry, I'm like all over the place because I'm
multitasking.
I'm not good at multitasking. But we're gonna make some Uncrustables. We picked them up yesterday from Target. And the way we've been eating them lately, or did you make it for yourself that way or just me?
The toasty?
Yeah.
No, for both of us.
So the way we've been eating them lately is we've been putting them in the toaster. One of my like longtime subscribers and friends told me her mom puts them in the toaster. So we've been doing that the past few times. They get so like nice and kind of crispy on the outside and like fluffy on the inside and just a little bit warm with the filling. It's really nice. So if you haven't tried that, if you have access to Uncrustables, give it a shot. It's really, really nice. So we're gonna have that. Do you wanna pop them in the toaster?
Yeah. You haven't tried those yet, right, actually?
No, I haven't. So why don't we like half and half? I'll try the honey peanut butter one. I actually have a lot of stuff to get done before my mom gets here. So I need to wrap gifts, obviously. I need to pick some gifts up. I need to grab stuff for stocking stuffers and then groceries and stuff I can do later. Maybe even when she's here because she's gonna be here on the 23rd. Then she can just like come pick stuff up with me. And it's just gonna be her, Sebastian, and I anyways. So we don't need to grab like a ton of stuff, which I would normally do if there was more people coming. But I am still gonna grab a good amount of stuff for Christmas dinner because Sebastian and I like to make a lot and then we have leftovers for like the next week and a half and it's the best thing ever. For Thanksgiving, we I think made a 19 pound turkey. I can't remember. I think it was 19 pounds. We ran out of it so fast. I feel like we had it for like a week and it was gone. I've been getting messages. I feel so bad. I haven't been posting vlogs for Vlogmas for the past several days. Going to Whistler definitely took out a big chunk of time that I would have normally spent editing. So I apologize that there haven't been many vlogs going up this Vlogmas. I feel really disappointed in myself, but it was hard to balance work with everything and then Whistler, but honestly, I really needed that trip away. We went to Whistler for my birthday and we basically spent the whole time in the hotel. We didn't really do very much there. So going this time during the winter was really nice because we haven't really gone anywhere except for Whistler for my birthday, like I said, for over 2 years. It was just really nice to get away and do some fun stuff and not feel like it was super pandemic-y, which is how it felt when we were there for my birthday. Let me do a little taste test of which one's which.
I don't know, you have to look inside.
That one looks like strawberry. So this is the honey one. I'm gonna do a little taste test. Mmm. Oh, it's so good. It tastes like a jam. It doesn't really taste like honey. Mmm.
I think you have the wrong one.
No, that's strawberry. No.
But there's peanut butter in mine. Do you have peanut butter in yours? Mm-hmm. So just the honey, that's the difference.
Mm. It doesn't taste like honey, but it's so good. Mm. So like gooey inside. I think I like honey most. No wonder you ate them all. You didn't want me to have any. You gave me the strawberry ones.
That's not true. Mm-hmm. I mean, kind of. I want you to have them, but also you didn't eat them. So I ate them. Do you want the other one? I'm offering.
That would be nice. Maybe when you go back across the border, if you do, you can buy a bunch more of the honey ones. I feel like it tastes extra good today. I don't know why. Little update. I just got my video up. Oh my gosh, I like can breathe again. That video was supposed to go up this morning. I thought I was gonna be like completely done editing, but then I started to watch it and I realized I had so much editing left to do. So all I did all day basically was edit the Whistler vlog. It was a beast to edit. It would have been a lot easier if I had done it like day by day. It is what it is. We got some fresh,
I didn't know
like
that.
Christmas tree.
You always remember the last vlog where she was just like,
I know, I'm aware.
Like, you keep doing this. You put your nose like all
over. I put my whole face.
Like, when I smell something, I do it like this. Like,
no, to me, I like want the whole experience. I just want to like immerse myself in it.
If you want the whole experience, you might as well just like
wear it. I don't know if you want to do that. We've been finding spiders everywhere. Do you want the spider experience too?
Do you think they came out of here?
No, but I think that they could have come out of there.
Oh my god.
I think, I don't know what it is, but we have so many spiders right now. Like, every time I look at the ceiling, there's new little spiders. I don't know if they came out of the tree because we had it in the backyard for a few days, or if it's that they're just like finding their way inside.
They didn't come out of this. We just got them.
Yeah, we just got these. You're freaking out now. You're like panicking.
I was just like, all the spiders in here, I just had it around my neck.
I know, but it smells so good. Anyways, we're gonna put these outside the house, around the door, which we did last. Did we do it last year? Yeah, we did.
I don't remember.
I think we went to Lowe's and got it last year. We're still doing last minute decorating. I wanted to also put the garland. Are those? It's Vlogmas day 18. I feel like I've done nothing.
If you wait another couple of days, you don't have to hang them up anymore because then Christmas is over.
I want to have it look cute in here for when my mom comes. So I have to put them up. These ones. I have to put those up on the cupboards. And
no, my advent calendar a long time.
Yeah, should we open it? Should we just do like a time lapse of us opening 12 days? I'm not joking, I think it's 12 days.
We can do it by like, who's the fastest? But who's gonna hold
the camera? Should we do a count? Like, should we like see who wins like overall?
Yeah, we can do it right now. Just leave it here.
I definitely can't eat 12 days of chocolate though. Like a little scoreboard or something?
Yeah, so six is the first day.
Six is the first day.
Okay, go. Five, three.
Seven golden rings.
Six.
Damn it.
And then we have to eat it really fast.
Alright, there's one. No, I can't eat this many chocolates.
Uh-huh. Seven. Got it.
No, I still can't find it. No, please. Wait, you have to wait for the next one. You have to wait
next
for
one's eight.
No, stop.
I found it.
Frick.
Next one's nine.
No.
I found it.
Josh, you gotta give me a chance. No, wait, you have to pause between each one.
Ten. I found it.
All right, so we already know Sebastian won. It's like not even count ten.
11. Here we go.
I still don't even have, I have 11. I don't have 9.
12. 13.
You were supposed to take a break between them.
Really? We didn't discuss that. 14. We're going, you need to catch up.
Sebastian, there's no way to catch up. I haven't gotten one first.
I'm going to stop at 15 and then we can do the next three ones with like whoever gets it first, okay?
Sad.
Can I help you?
No, I still need to get 9, I think. 9. Yeah. That's a lot of candy. How about we do the other ones tomorrow? Because then you at least maybe forget about where they
That's
are.
That's true. I will forget.
And you. I'm going to grab the calendars tomorrow. It's just the luck of whoever grabs them. Come back in front. Yours is creepy. We went to Trader Joe's and Target last night. Tried to stock up on some of our frozen items because we're not going to be going back through probably for a while. I'm going to say this. All I've had today so far is like sweet stuff. So I don't want to eat too much. Otherwise, I'll get a stomachache. So tonight, it's late now. 6:20. We didn't eat lunch until really late, so I'm not hungry yet. But my goal is to shower, wash my hair, and blow dry it. I washed my hair last night, and I didn't blow dry it. Like, dried really ugly. So I have to do that. And then I can tell you guys a little review of my new shampoo and conditioner set. And then also I really wanna try the Perfecting Leave-In from the Lolavie. I think what I'm gonna do tonight is I'm going to wrap gifts. I've only wrapped a couple things so far. I also need to do some Christmas shopping later for people I have not purchased things for yet. Okay, it's my sister. I haven't bought my sister's gift yet.
But we know what it is.
I do know what I'm getting. I took a shower, changed my clothes. I have this weird thing about showering. Every time I shower, I have to put on new clothes. Do you have that too?
Yeah, even the feeling of cleanliness, like new clothes.
Even if I'm wearing new clothes before I shower, I have to change.
I have that too.
We're gonna make cacio e pepe. I would say that wrong.
What is it?
It's, well, I make it fresh sometimes, but I follow an influencer and she loves this. She says it's so good. Cheese and pepper.
Spaghetti pasta in a rich creamy sauce with pecorino romano cheese. Okay, so how do you make it? So it's just basically pasta.
On the stove. Cacio e pepe is really easy to make as it is. It's one of the easiest dishes, so.
Okay.
This must be like extra easy if you're gonna package it. This is what we're gonna have.
No, this is what you are going to have. I'm gonna have this.
We are gonna have this. You have some of it. This is not big enough.
Oh.
That's nothing.
Okay, I didn't know that. I just thought it's this yours and this mine, but I'm okay with like having some of yours.
Alright, we're gonna taste test this cacio e pepe. You pepe?
It's so long.
It's actually really good.
Yeah.
I like the texture of the pasta, but I did not like that it was sticking to the pan so much. It's also very spicy. The noodles remind me of more like bucatini noodles. You too?
What are bucatini noodles?
The ones with the hole in the middle and then they're more chewy.
They're so,
I really like them. Very peppery. I just need to figure out a better way to like actually cook them because they really stuck to my pan. I need to actually like buy groceries and set myself up to make better vlogs where I can actually show meals.
Yeah.
As of late, we've been living off of frozen meals.
Trader Joe's.
How's that one?
Huh.
Really hot?
It tastes good, but it's too hot. You want to try this?
Vegetarian, right? Like the pepperoni?
It's vegetarian.
I don't know about this.
Why?
It doesn't look great. Are you trying to like trick me into eating this?
No, it tastes good. It's good. What? You like it?
The flavor is really good.
Yeah.
But the pepperoni tastes like dough. It tastes like uncooked pizza dough. That's really weird. I do like the flavor, but the pepperoni is weird. Try it.
I haven't had a piece yet.
Of the pepperoni?
Yeah.
Tastes like raw pizza dough.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
So it's a little bit later. I'm going to blow dry my hair now. And I told you guys in my last video and the video before that one that I would keep you guys updated on how I feel about the Lolavie products. This is the leave-in perfector, I think it is, or perfecting leave-in. I think it's like a leave-in conditioner type product, but it also serves as like a heat protectant and helps with style and stuff. I did use the glossing detangler by itself, and I kind of gave a little mini review in my Whistler vlog. I really love how that product works with my hair. My hair is long, but I've been trying extra hard lately to take care of it because I'm trying to grow out a lot of broken hair. But what I really like about the glossing detangler, apart from the fact that it detangles, is that it made my hair feel very weightless and clean. And I think it kept my hair in a clean state, or what looked clean and felt clean, for a lot longer than what my hair typically is like after several days without washing. So I think I went like 4 days without washing my hair. But I also was in a different climate, and that could have had something to do with it. But what I did like was that my hair stayed looking pretty nice for at least 4 days. Today I'm gonna try out the perfecting leave-in by itself and see how this performs, because I am curious. So I'm using 2 pumps. And then after I'm done, I'll go over some of the other things I've been doing for my hair lately. I have been noticing a really big difference, and I thought I would go over the Oribe products that I told you I would update you on. I actually had a question about that, and I thought I would go over some of the other things I've been doing, like the Olaplex, and then also some other like miscellaneous things that I've been doing to my hair. Off the bat, love the smell of her hair products. This perfector has like a almost like citrus smell to it. It gives me citrus, almost like white tea vibes. Another funny thing is it seems to be also detangling my hair right now. I wasn't expecting that. This is definitely helping me get my fingers through my hair much easier. I really like that it seems like my hair is kind of sucking the product up, if that makes sense. Like, I don't feel this like greasy feeling. Ordinarily, I would be using the Oribe Gold Lust Nourishing Hair Oil as well. I've been using this a lot lately, but I'm just gonna use this product by itself. So I finished blow drying my hair and I absolutely love this product. I think they are both amazing products, but on their own, they're also very nice. The glossing detangler, like I said, it makes your hair feel more clean and weightless kind of and a little bit more flingy. Whereas this product, the perfecting leave-in, it gives your hair more of that, like, it's almost like a styling cream. It gives you a very sleek look, but at the same time, almost being more full. It's a really nice product. It's more of like a styling product, I would say, like a styling cream than a conditioner, which is what I thought it was initially. They are both fantastic products. If you guys try them out, I hope you guys love them as much as I do. And if you do try them out, or if you have, let me know in the comments. I'd like to know your guys' opinions. So now that I've finished blow drying my hair, I thought I would talk about a few of the things that I've been doing lately to try to nurse my hair back to health. My hair, most of my hair is actually about shoulder length, shockingly. My goal is to thicken up my ends again, overall take better care of my hair. I was talking to a friend a while back and she was showing me pictures of her hair and how much it's grown, and it really inspired me to actually start taking better care of my hair. Her hair looked so beautiful. The first thing I did was I started to use argan oil, and the one that I had on hand was the oil, extra virgin argan oil, Miracle from AG. I've had this stuff forever. I'm almost done the bottle now. I was using so much of it. It gives you a really nice, shiny, silky appearance to your hair. It was great for like blow drying. I haven't used it in a while because I've been using the Oribe Gold Lust, which I'll get into in a minute. And another product that I use every single time I blow dry my hair, apart from the past few times because I've been testing out some new products, is the ColorWOW Dream Coat Supernatural Spray. This stuff is amazing. I've gone through like 3 bottles of it. Kim Kardashian's hairstylist uses this on her. She had a period where her hair was like in a bob and it was very, very straight. And I was like, how does she have zero flyaways? How does her hair look so silky? No frizz, nothing. And one of the products that her hairstylist uses, he uses this on her. This is a really great product for humidity. It makes my hair very shiny, very glossy. It doesn't add any weight, doesn't add any texture. It just makes your hair extra smooth. It says magically transforms texture, amazing humidity proofing powers. Award-winning humidity sealant stops hair from becoming a hot mess even in the highest humidity. Activated by heat, long-lasting, lasts through 3 to 4 shampoos. After like a few times of using it, my hair would feel so silky. It was like when I would shampoo my hair, the feeling after having shampooed my hair felt like I had already conditioned it. That makes sense. I'm not saying it does anything amazing for helping protect your hair, but I really like the effect of what it does when you blow dry your hair with it. So another thing that I've been using recently, and this stuff is amazing, it is worth the hype, is the Olaplex Hair Perfector number 3. I've used this much of it. I've probably used this now like 4 times. I use it once a week and it's great for apparently damaged hair. I should get Sebastian to try it, but he hasn't. But I've been loving it because it makes my hair feel stronger. So I definitely notice a huge difference when I'm blow drying my hair. I have less hair in the brush after I'm done blow drying my hair. So that's kind of how I've been assessing whether or not it's working. So another thing I've been looking into is how to use less heat on my hair. I got this like contraption thing that you're supposed to braid your hair around and it gives you really nice heatless curls. I haven't managed to actually get it to work on me yet. I think because I have so much hair to deal with. When I use it with my hair damp, which is what you're supposed to do, my hair ends up staying damp all the way till morning. I have to figure out like maybe drying my hair more before using this. So another thing I've been trying to use lately is the silk hair turban thing. These had a moment a couple years ago. I saw them everywhere. They were always on Instagram and stuff. And this is actually a really great product if you can make it work. I've been struggling. I don't like the feeling of something tight around my face, and it's not that this is very tight, it's just that I can feel it and I'm aware of something on my temples. I was using this pretty regularly when I got it and I made it work then. I don't know why I can't get it to work now. I ordinarily sleep on flannel pillowcases because I find them so comfortable. It's probably the worst fabric you could sleep on because it absorbs all of the oils in your hair and makes your hair look extra frizzy. I have all the best intentions. I go to sleep with it on. I've been sleeping with it on for the past couple months, and then I just rip it off in the middle of the night. Whenever I've used it and slept through the night with it on, my hair looked amazing the next day. It makes your hair very soft. You don't have any tangles. You go to sleep with a blowout, your hair looks just as nice the next day. I've even had like curls in my hair and went to sleep and had my curls last through the night. I might try to actually like cut the elastic inside of it and pin it to my hair, like with some clips or something. Okay, so moving into the last thing that I'm gonna talk about hair related. I told you guys in a few vlogs ago that I bought the Oribe Gold Lust collection. I bought this during the Sephora sale in November, and this is the Repair and Restore line. So I have the Gold Lust Repair and Restore shampoo, the Gold Lust Repair and Restore conditioner, and the Gold Lust Nourishing Hair Oil. So this is what the packaging looks like. I actually really like the look of the packaging. So this stuff is very pricey. I do really like it. I haven't decided if the shampoo and conditioner are worth the cost yet. What I do notice about the shampoo and the conditioner, I don't know if it's them together or if it's one of them, but what I notice is that it gives my hair the feeling of when I've just had it dyed darker and my cuticle feels sealed. It makes my hair strands feel smoother. They feel less textured and less frizzy. They feel almost like glossier. It definitely makes my hair feel nicer, but I'm not certain yet if they're worth the price because there might be better shampoos and conditioners out there. I will say I do like this better than the shampoo and conditioner I was using before, which was from AG, and I thought that was like my holy grail, but I just can't decide if they're worth the price yet. So that being said, the hair oil is amazing. I didn't think I was gonna like it. I thought I had already found a really great hair oil, but what is so amazing about this is that it doesn't weigh my hair down. My hair is kind of finicky with hair oil, so there is definitely a sweet spot. If I use beyond that sweet spot, my hair looks greasy and oily. It feels heavy. I've gone heavy with this stuff and not had my hair weighed down. It's almost like my hair just absorbs all of it. It makes my hair dry much faster, even without a blow dryer. It makes my hair very shiny and silky and smooth and amazing, and I wish I didn't like it because it's so ridiculously expensive, and I will be rebuying it once I'm done. The good news is I've been using it pretty regularly, and it almost seems like I've not used any of it. I think the whole bottle still looks like it's completely full. What I would do is if you want to try it out, go to Sephora, ask them for a sample of it, try it out after a few washes. Out of the three, this is definitely my favorite. I really do like the shampoo and conditioner, but like I said, I haven't decided yet if what I'm getting out of it is actually worth the cost. Those are the things I've been doing to try to take care of my hair lately. If you guys have any tips that you want to leave me, anything that made a big difference, let me know in the comments because I would really love any advice. I've even been looking into like hair supplements. There's one called, I think, Nutrafol, and then there's another competitor, and I don't remember what the name of that one is, but I've been seeing the ads on the Hallmark channel that I have over and over and over again, and I've been considering getting something like that, but they do have biotin in them and my skin does not react well to biotin. Out of the things that I've been doing, the things that I think have the biggest impact on my hair have been the Olaplex Hair Perfector. This has really made my hair a lot stronger, and the Oribe Nourishing Oil. So I think what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to wrap a bunch of gifts. I wanna get them done as early as I can because usually what happens is on Christmas Eve, I'm wrapping gifts until the early hours of the morning, and I don't wanna have anything to wrap on Christmas Eve. I might just wrap a bunch of gifts and then bow them and tag them tomorrow and do like a wrapping session, put on a Christmas movie. Which Christmas movie should we watch?
We could watch the his name is Christmas, or the boy's name is
Christmas. We haven't seen that one yet. I kind of want to hit some of the movies that I really love that I haven't watched yet, though. Have I watched? No, I haven't watched Santa Claus 2 yet.
We started it.
Yeah. I haven't seen Home Alone yet. Haven't watched Elf.
Oh yeah.
I haven't watched Elf. Haven't seen some of my favorite Hallmark movies, and I haven't caught up on any of the Hallmark movies.
Hallmark probably released like 50 movies or so.
Since I haven't watched, yeah. So we're gonna have some wine, and I guess the next footage you guys will see will be a montage footage of me wrapping gifts. What do you think of my hair?
Looks beautiful. So shiny.
Well, what's your take on it? What do you think? Does it look different at all?
It looks more fluffy.
Fluffy? What do you mean?
Like voluptuous.
Voluptuous?
Like, well, it looks like it has a lot more volume right now. Yeah.
And what else?
It looks very shiny.
Shiny? No, that's actually really good.
I was just about to say that I don't know what's going on right now.
I was reviewing because I used the Lolavie Perfecting Leave-In today.
Oh yeah, I didn't know
And I reviewed it. Good observation, because that's exactly what I said, was that it makes your hair feel more full, but it still has like this sleekness to it. End the vlog, but before I do, I thought I would give you an update on the silk cap situation. Last night, what I did is I took a pair of small scissors, I just cut the thread for the piece of fabric that covers the elastic, and then I snipped the elastic. So the elastic's still in here, and if I wanted to reattach them, I could probably just sew them back together. But I was able to sleep with this on the entire night, and my hair feels so incredibly soft today. It doesn't really have any kinks in it, even though I did sleep with it in. I wrapped it into a bun and put it on top of my head and then put this over top. My hair is a lot more smooth looking than it would be if I just went to sleep and slept on a normal pillow. I'm hoping that if I continue to use this every night for several months, I will see an improvement in my hair, and maybe I'll just have to follow up and kind of keep you guys posted to see which of the things that I'm doing actually helps. So that's gonna be it. I know today's video was very hair focused, and I promise the next vlogs will be more Christmas heavy because I have a lot of prep to do before my mom gets here. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed today's vlog. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you're all having a wonderful holiday season and enjoying time with your families and loved ones, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye guys.
Christmas.